So good morning, my dear students. Yesterday we were discussing question answers of the chapter My Childhood. We were not able to complete those questions, so let's continue with the same one. We were able to complete only these second question. First part we were explaining to you. I have given you so many hints. We have discussed traits of father, mother, and Abdul Kalam himself. So with the help of that, you could frame your answer, and your response was good in that answer. So what characteristics does he say he inherited from his parents? So these hints that I have provided you for first answer, it is same like that, but we will discuss in detail also. So in first answer, we have come to know that father was full of quality, mother was also full of qualities. Okay, so many good qualities they were having. Okay, so but what characteristic, what traits, what qualities did he has adopted? Did he have, you can say, what characteristic, what personality traits he had inherited, he had taken, he had adopted from his parents. Okay, so let's work on this. Okay, now I want my good student, all students are good if they participate in class. Okay, so bache, start participating, and you just tell me what characteristic did he adopt from his parents. So hurry, tell me, type in chat box. I give you one hint that he had learned self-discipline. Yes, self-discipline. Okay, and another trait, self-discipline he had learned from his father. Okay, other traits that he had learned from his father, let me read your chat box. Honesty, humility. Okay, yes, other students, yes, hurry up, kindness. Okay, so self-discipline, this trait he has learned from his father. Okay, and afterwards, what trait he learned from his mother? Yes, what a sense of kindness. Yes, faith in God. Faith in God, and so many points that we have discussed yesterday, you can also add up in your answer. You can add up all those points also that we have discussed yesterday. So many points I have told you. So who is going to tell me this answer? Okay, first of all, Riddhima. After Riddhima, Pranay, you should be ready, and while giving answer, your camera should be on.
The author inherited humility and benevolence from his parents. He learned lessons in honesty and integrity from his parents. He was self-disciplined because of his parents' exemplary life. His parents also teach how to sit in together and eat food together with lots of people, and how to help everyone. And especially, he learned from his mother that we should kind to everyone and help everyone.
Yes. So it means he learned that there should not be any kind of, because when you were speaking lines, that he learned how to sit together, how to take food together. So in between, you can add up this line that he learned that not to discriminate anyone on the basis of caste, creed, etc. Okay. So add up that line. Otherwise, your answer was good. Pranay, now you keep your video on. Show me your face. Show me your face. Then you speak your answer. Pranay. So Pranay, shall I remove you from my class? It means it is a fake ID. Okay, I'm going to remove you. I know it is fake. Removed by me, it is reported also. report has been submitted. So now next to Diren, why are you passing a smile? Why are you so happy? Because he was not keeping his camera on. I gave him warning also in beginning. It means he is fake. So Arzu, you tell me this answer. But first of all, keep your camera on. Show me your face. Arzu? Arzu? See, in English class, if only I speak, I tell you the answer, I explain. So what will be the benefit of English class? In English class, I'm providing you a hint. And with the help of those hints, you are supposed to give me answer. So Arzu beta, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The APJ Abdul Kalam says that he inherited honesty and self.
APJ Abdul Kalam, it is right. Why are you putting the? Write down APJ Abdul Kalam.
Ma'am, I have said APJ Abdul Kalam.
Okay.
I have not. APJ okay. Abdul Kalam says that he inherited honesty and self-discipline from his father. He also says that he inherited kindness and faith in godness from his mother. And
only this much? So many hints were provided to you yesterday. It means you haven't written on your book.
Am I written?
So pick up all those hints also.
And
after Arzu, Ritik and this Mitansh should be ready with the same answer. Ritik and Mitansh. Arzu put efforts, beta. Ritik, you tell me.
Every child is born with some inherited characteristics. APJ Abdul Kalam was APJ Abdul Kalam inherited honesty and self-discipline from his father, and inherited a faith in godness and kindness from his mother, and also inherited a true spirit, how to be the true spirit of love to others, and also inherited that not to discriminate others on the basis of religion, caste and color, etc.
Okay, well tried. Whatever you have spoken, it was right. But so many points were discussed with you in detail yesterday. Pick up all those points, because I told you so many times yesterday that you are supposed to write down all those points in your rough notebook or on your book using a pencil. Only then you'll be able to frame good answers.
Ma'am, I have written on my book.
And pick up all those points. Pick up. Now, Mitansh.
1-2 minutes.
Mitansh.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, beta. Yes, bachcha, tell me.
APJ Abdul Kalam inherited many things from his parents. Like, he inherited discipline and honesty from his father, and godness and kindness from his mother. And he also inherited that the discrimination should not be done on any basis.
See, so many traits we have discussed about father and mother, and there were different kind of traits. Let me see that you are keeping your cameras on or not. Okay, because his father was basically a man of that he used to fulfill the needs of his family. Okay, so he was strict, but he was loving also, caring also, but he was a man of discipline. So that's why he has adopted that trait, that self-discipline he has learned from his father. And mother, what kind of lady she was? She was a God-fearing lady. She was had a great faith in God. Okay, she was true epitome of kindness. So such kind of sense of kindness, to have a faith in God, okay, not to discriminate on the basis of anything. All these traits he has adopted, he has inherited from his mother. Okay. Now, bachche, let's move to next question. Next question we have is, discuss these questions in class with your teacher and then write your own answer in 2 or 3 paragraphs each. On the whole, the small society of Rameswaram was very rigid in terms of the segregation of different social groups, says the author. So according to this chapter, what is written in this chapter, we have come to know that Rameswaram was a very small, Rameswaram was such kind of area in which you can say segregation of different social groups. When it is done, they were very much rigid, they were very much strictly related to that. It means they never wanted that their society should be divided in different parts. Okay. So which kind of social societies, which kind of social groups does he mention? And were these groups easily identifiable for the way they dressed? Because if you have gone through the chapter, there is a one incident when he was in fifth class and he was sitting in class, one of the teacher came. So how did teacher discriminate? How did teacher come to know that this is a Hindu and this is a Muslim? Why? Because APJ Abdul Kalam, he was wearing white cap. So who wears white cap just like that? Muslims, okay? And there was one Hindu boy who was wearing that sacred holy thread. In Hindi, what do we say? Janeu. That is worn on the body like that in slant position. Okay, it is of white color. Okay, and it is a sacred thread. These are worn by Hindu Brahmins. So how a teacher came to know from these, you can say dressing sense, from these dressing code, teacher came to know that this boy is a Hindu and this boy is a Muslim. And it is this great example is given in your chapter. Okay, so you pick up those hints. With the help of those hints, you tell me which were the social groups which are mentioned in the chapter and how they were easily identifiable, how one could easily recognize that it is of Muslim and it is of Hindu. Now, who is going to tell me this answer? Raise your hand. Get ready with your answer. Hurry up. Hurry up, bachche. Two special groups, Hindu and Muslim, they are being described. Okay? Because they have different dress code, they have different rituals, they have different traditions and culture. And I have given you one example when he was in fifth class. How did teacher notice that it was Hindu or it was Muslim? How did teacher come to know? So this answer I expect from Ramanjeet. Ramanjeet, roll number 32. After Ramanjeet, Nitya should be ready. Those who are not showing their face, I'm going to remove them from my class. Because I know these are fake IDs. If these are not fake IDs, what are you doing? Why are you not responding in class? Ramanjeet. Removed by me. Now, Nitya, you tell me this answer.
Ma'am, first part.
Yes.
The social group mentioned by the author were mainly Hindus, Brahmins, and Muslims. These groups were easily recognizable as the Muslims wore white hats and Hindu Brahmins wore threads around their waist, around their body. In one situation, we can also see that a teacher discriminated as when APJ Abdul Kalam was in fifth grade and he was sitting with a Hindu Brahmin. The teacher told APJ Abdul Kalam to stand up and go to the back of the class as he was sitting with a Hindu Brahmin.
Very good. Perfectly explained. Very good. Keep it up. It means now your performance is improving, Nitya. You are a very good writer, but you don't participate in class. Earlier, you were not participating, but nowadays, you are responding well. That is good. Keep it up. And you should also raise your hand. When you know the answer, you should be very much enthusiastic and confident to give the answer. Now your answer was perfect. Because to elaborate this answer, whatever you have to do, bache, you have to take social groups example, which were mentioned in this chapter. See, I think when we have gone through the chapter, we have come to know Hindu group. We have come to know about Muslim group. Okay, we have taken the example of class 5 when teacher came there. Teacher saw one of the boy who was wearing white, not hat, right, then white cap. I think one of the students spoke hat. So it was basically cap and Hindu Brahmin boy, he was wearing a sacred thread. So from all these, you can say dress code, teacher really very easily came to know that this is a Hindu boy and this is a Muslim boy. So you can add up all these details in your answer. So now, bache, let's move to question number second. Were they aware only of their differences or did they also naturally share friendship and experiences? Think of the bedtime stories in Kalam's house of his friends were and of what used to take part in the pond near his house. Very good question. Okay. See, those children, they were aware about these differences that my friend is a Hindu and this friend is a Muslim. Okay. They were aware of this thing. Tell me yes or no. You have to mention this answer in yes or no form. Then you have to elaborate their experience, their friendship. See, when APJ Abdul Kalam was having three friends, you have to mention their name, you have to mention their caste, creed, their religion, which kind of religion did they belong, and it is straight away given in the chapter in a very simple lines. You can pick up those lines and you can tell me the answer. So you can tell me this answer. Who is ready with that? Jasleen Khosla, keep your video on, then you will be given a chance to speak. It is near about 11:09 and you all should be, I think, ready by the time. You could keep your camera on. You can keep your camera on and give me the answer. Okay. So I can ask this answer from any of the child who will not keep their camera on. They will be marked absent and they will be removed from my class. Divyanshi, your answer is ready. Divyanshi, have you written the answer? In this answer, you have to only take the names of his three childhood friends. Okay. And from this, it was crystal clear that they were not aware of the discrimination of Hindu and Muslims. And you can also mention about the bedtime stories that were taken from Ramayana and they were taken from the life of Prophet. These stories were told by his mother. Okay. And one more example that Kalam's family, they used to arrange boards. And for whom they used to arrange boards? For carrying idols of Hindus' gold. So from these all examples, it is crystal clear that there was a complete cooperation between Hindus and Muslims. They were not aware of the differences. They were surviving their life. They were leading their life in a very normal way. They were not aware of this thing. So bache, pick up all the hints. With the help of these hints, you frame your answer. From all these examples, it is very much clear. It is very much crystal clear that they were not hating each other, Hindu and Muslims. They were friends of each other. See, Abdul Kalam's family, they used to arrange one boat in which they were carrying idols of Hindus' god. And they were Muslims. It means they were not having any discrimination. They were having complete cooperation. Even during bedtime, mother used to tell stories from Ramayana. So how could they hate Hindu religion? And Muslims and Hindus, they all were friends. So there are so many examples. Jasleen, keep your camera on, otherwise I'm going to remove you from my class. So Simran, you tell me this answer. Show me your face, Jasleen. Show me your face. Not give me answer. So many times I'm shouting in class that keep your cameras on, but you people are least bothered.
Kalam has mentioned his three childhood friends, and all of them had Hindu names, so their friendship was evident. Kalam has mentioned about the bedtime stories from the Ramayana, the life of the prophet being told by his mother. Moreover, Kalam's family used to arrange boats for carrying idols of Hindu gods. This explains the natural Hindu-Muslim cooperation in most parts of India. They were aware of the different identities, but they were living normal. They were living in the normal society, and they were not bothering about the differences. They were naturally sharing their friendship experiences with each other.
Okay, good. Now next time now your camera should be on. Okay, you have given a very good answer. Your answer was perfect. You have added all the points whatever I have discussed. So why don't you keep your camera on? What is the problem? Tell me. Yesterday also I was shouting like a mad person class and keep your camera on. It can be a fake ID. It can be a fake ID. But you were least bothered. Don't give me a chance to scold you, beta. You are grown up. You are studying in 9th class. So be mature. Grow up. Don't get scolding. Get encouraging words from your teacher. If you know the answer, keep your camera on. Be confident. Come in front of screen and tell the answer and create a good impression. Bachi, I am making a list of all those students who are regular absentees, and these names I'm going to give in the office within 1 or 2 days. I'm waiting for you. I'm making attendance register. Those who are continuously absent in my class, these names will be given in the office and their parents will be called. You will come along with your parent here. You have to mention the reason why did you remain absent in English class. I will show the register. I will show all the screenshots that this child did not come in my class. He was a regular absentee. Then you will be answerable. You will be answerable then. Vanshika Nagpal, keep your camera on. Vanshika Nagpal, keep your camera on. Get ready by the time Simran is giving answer. Okay, Vanshika has come. Okay, no problem. Vanshika, give me answer. Give me same answer. You unmute yourself. Unmute yourself, hurry up. Yes.
Yes, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, bachche. Yes, tell me answer.
Which question?
Which question is going on? You were where? Where were you? You were taking having breakfast or lying on the bed and taking rest? You were having your breakfast or you were watching TV? Or you were in another room and your laptop was in another room? Tell me.
Mom, I was having my breakfast.
I know this thing. And what were you doing during break? Sleeping?
No, I'm taking bath.
Oh my God, very big, very busy routine. I should feel sympathetic with you. Your class starts at 8:30, and before 8:30, you don't think that you should be ready. You should take bath. You should be ready, comb your hair, and dress up like a nice person, isn't it? Tell me.
Yes, ma'am.
My routine is like that. My class starts at 8:30, and before 8:30, I get ready. And during break, I take my breakfast. I have also a break of 20 minutes like you. And within 20 minutes, I take my breakfast and I come back. Why don't you adopt the same routine? Before 8:30, you should get ready. And during break, you should take your breakfast. So tomorrow,
okay, ma'am.
Set up your routine.
Okay, ma'am.
Now tell me answer.
Which question?
Third is going
on. Third.
Having your breakfast, ma'am. Third answer was going on in the class.
Now okay, ma'am. One minute.
You are looking.
Ma'am, 1 minute.
Keep your camera on. Tell me third answer.
1 minute.
You take 2 minutes. We are free. All are free, all are waiting for you. Still taking breakfast?
No, ma'am, I have to 1 minute read the question and...
Question is right in front of you. I thought your breakfast is left and you are finishing it.
No, ma'am, I have finished it already.
Thank you so much. You have finished. We all are happy with you. Your breakfast is finished. Now come to the question. All are having a huge smile on their face. That Vanshika has finished her breakfast. Vanshika, I think she is still thinking about her breakfast. Her breakfast was so yummy. She is still relishing it. Let's move to Simran. Simran, you tell me this answer. I don't want to waste much time. Vanshika, by the time after Simran, you should be ready with your answer.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, Simran. Yes,
ma'am. APJ Abdul Kalam was born in a poor family and belonged to Muslim. But on the other hand, all his three friends belonged to Orthodox Hindu families and were well known and from rich families. But this didn't change the fact they were all friends and cooperative. They didn't even discriminate each other and were happy with each other. They never ever thought how they belonged to different social backgrounds and castes. They were not aware only of their differences. They also naturally shared friendships and experiences. Kalam's mother and grandmother would tell events from the Ramayana and from the life of the prophet as bedtime stories. All his friends belonged to Orthodox, as I said, Hindu families. During the annual Sita Rama Kalyanam ceremony, his family would arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of the Lord from the temple to the marriage site situated in the middle of the pond called Rama Tirtha, which was near his house.
Very good.
This shows how the Hindus and Muslims were cooperative in the Ramanatha and also how they were happy with each other and never discriminated.
Very good. Perfectly. You have arranged all the ideas systematically as they are given in the chapter. You have picked up all the whatever I have told you, whatever your perspective, whatever the points you have got from the book, all the ideas are properly arranged. I'm really proud of such kind of students. Very good. Now, Vanshika, start.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Abdul Kalam was born in a Muslim family, but all his friends belonged to Hindu community, but there was never an issue of religion between them. His three friends were Ramananda Sastri Arvindan and Siva Praksan were his school friends. Ramananda Sastri became a priest of the Rameshwaram temple Arvindan went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims and Siva Praksan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways. Three of them have a very strong bond of friendship and they always have cooperated with each other in all their phases of life.
Phases of life. But there is no need to tell about the description of the, you can say, friends. What did they become in their life? In this answer, you just do not beat about the bush. Come to the point. Three points we are supposed to add. The first one is that the friendship episodes you have to take. Second, you have to tell that they were not aware of that. They were having Hindu friends or Muslim friends. They were not having any, you can say, religious differences. And one more episode you can tell about bedtime stories. You can elaborate in detail. Then they arranged one boat for carrying idol of Lord Rama's. So all these episodes you can pick up from your text and you can do. Now, bachche, I want to tell you that on Saturday, you will have a test of the snake and the mirror and editing. And this test will be done in the form of a Google form. Okay, at the same time, when as soon as you will submit the test, marks will be in front of you. Okay, so it will be assessed very easily. But now I'm going to share one editing practice with you. So let's do this and you all get ready with that and you all should show enthusiasm. for that. Tell me, screen is visible to you? Show me thumbs up if screen is visible to you. No? Wait. Now I have taken this editing practice in front of you. Okay, I will be sharing first one. Okay, and you tell me there is one word that is missing. Okay, and you have to add up that word. So let's start from 18th. We will be doing last one first because it is the easiest one. His son is an only one who takes, but word is missing. Type in chat box. Hurry up. His son is an only one who takes. I have taken practice of editing and omission. It is a practice of editing. See, an is the correct answer. His son is an only one. An is correct. Now tell me in place of an, what word will be there? You have to replace the word. What will come in place of an? I have given you one example. His son is the only one. Okay? You have to omit an in place of an. You have to write down the. His son is the only one who takes care of him. He has because very old. He has. Tell me, because? In place of because, what will come? I'm reading from, yes, very good. Jayati, Dhiren, Simran, all are typing correct answer. He has become very old. Okay, so in place of because, become will come. He must not even sit. He must not even. In place of must, what will come? Very good, Ekjot, Simran, very good. Type in chat box your answer. Very good. Yes, he cannot. Yes. In place of must, what will come? He cannot even sit and stand. He needs. He needs no her son's help. In place of her, what will come? He needs his son's help. Okay. So in this way, you have to make correction. And for single correction, you are going to score one mark. And you do it very, very carefully. Now let's do 17th. Many new gadgets have been invented. In place of invent, what will come? Invented. Very good. Type in chat box. Hurry up. During the last century, many most are being. Many most. In place of most, many more are being. Your time is running out. Your class can be over at any time, but we can finish it. And I will be sharing this on WhatsApp also. I will be sharing answers also. You solve it. And tomorrow I will provide you answers. You can check your answers that it is right or wrong. Clear, bachche? I'm going to share it on in WhatsApp English group, 9th English group. You do its practice. On next day, I will be sharing answers with you. Clear, beta? We will continue this topic tomorrow also.